Hey everyone, welcome to Gospel Music USA. My name is Danny Jones. I'm with Singing News Magazine.
I'm Karen Peck Gooch with Karen Peck and New River.
I'm Mike Lefevre with the Lefevre Quartet. And we're so glad you've joined us today for some great gospel music.
Yes. And now that our roll call is completed, we want to tell you a little bit about our guest today. Now, those of you who grew up in the 30s, 40s, 50s, you remember Western music. Well, these guys, and Karen is one of those, these guys specialize in taking that Western flair, mixing it with some classic gospel songs, and the result, well, it is just simply outstanding.
Fantastic.
Now, you know there's nothing like harmony. You guys know that because
That's
of what you do. But every now and then, sometimes you just have to step out a little bit and do a song by yourself. And that's what we're going to start our program with today. So everybody, if you will give your full attention to these folks, I know you will enjoy them. Here is Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. Make them welcome.
This is a song my dad wrote back in 1958. I think it's a beautiful song. I hope it'll bless your heart. I love this life. I see
Welcome back to Gospel Music USA, your home on the television for great Southern gospel music. Is it not, Mike?
It is.
There you go. All right, our guest today, Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. We've got something truly different here today, don't we, Karen?
We do. And you know, you all really are very special. I mean, just every one of you, you have your own stories, and to think that you've come together and you've got this great new thing going. You know, it's new, but yet it's nostalgic. So tell us a little bit, Johnny, how this became about.
Well, we've known one another for many, many years. I was 14 or 15 when we first met. So I'm something like that old now.
He's 14 going on 20.
Well, there you go.
We sang together in a group back in the 70s and before we all went our own separate ways. And I had an occasion about 6 or 7 years ago where I pastored to bring in another associate pastor. Phil had been pastoring for 28 years out in the Bay Area in California. And he said that he would come and help me with the church. And Lonnie followed him. And when we all got back together again, we said, why don't we sing a few songs?
Just meant to be, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was just one of those things that God puts together that you don't even know it's going to happen until it happens.
Well, what made you decide it? Listen, you have to keep this going, this look, because what made you decide to go with the Western wear? I mean, I know it fits the music, but...
Well, as we mentioned a while ago, we did a special service at the church, and we sang Tumbling Tumbleweeds.
Yeah.
We wore cowboy hats and Western clothes.
I played my accordion.
He played an accordion.
Played the guitar, and he played the bass.
It was a big hit.
When y'all are actually doing concerts, do you play the instrument?
Yeah.
So when this group goes out to different events, What is the reaction from the audience? Because, I mean, let's be honest about it. There is no other group in gospel music quite like Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. When you first walk out, especially on a program where people may not be familiar with you, what is the reaction? What is the first thing that you notice when you walk out on the platform?
I think they look the way we're dressed, first of all. They're trying to figure that out. But I think the newest song we sing, it was written about 1962. So when we start singing, you see everybody's mouth moving because they're singing right along with us. They know all of those old songs.
Well, now, you know, and a lot of our audiences today include the opposite of the silver hair. We're seeing some young folks in our audience. What is their reaction when the younger folks, I mean, are they... I feel like they would absolutely love, what
the
they do.
Yeah.
Right.
They love it. When we start singing, they start, comes back around.
Zoning in on
when they hear it, they love it.
One thing about our music, the most of the people that like our style of music, they appreciate harmony.
Right.
And y'all have got just a beautiful harmony.
Thank you.
And that's that, along with the fact that you're doing some songs that they recognize, and you can win them
just
like that.
This is another thing I think is wonderful about it, is that makes you so unique, is the fact that you're singing these classic country western songs, but you're singing the classic hymns and, you know, classic songs from back when. And we have two preachers. Am I right? Are you a preacher?
He can, though.
But
you
necessary.
Have two pastors that, you know, that know the importance of, you know, bringing it all back in and talking about Jesus. And you never know when someone comes to see you and that'll be the last thing event they'll ever go to. Right. You can lead them to the Lord. And what a great ministry that is as well.
Well, you know, Karen, we really tried to pick songs that have messages to them, that if you just listen to the words, they're going to speak to your heart. God will use them to speak to your heart. And we see that. Had very strong spiritual overtides in some of the services when you start singing, when he reached down his hand for me.
Yeah.
And I was lost and undone without God or his son.
Don't preach.
Yeah, that'll preach.
I said, don't preach.
You know, speaking of that, you know, a good song, as we all know, a good song never goes away. It's just recycled. Of the song that you're doing, what is your favorite song? Let's start with you.
I think I would have to go with When He Reached Down His Hand.
It's a great song. And you?
Just a Closer Walk with Thee.
And Johnny, I mean, you're in all different styles. Go ahead.
When He Reached Down His Hand, that's everybody's testimony.
Johnny does a great job.
That is a thread that runs through every soul.
Right.
Because nobody is worthy of God's love, yet God so loved. And when you think about how great he is, and then think about us, how far he had to reach, I don't think lyrics could put it any better than When He Reached Way Down for me.
Well, no doubt about it, gospel music is embraces so many different styles. Yeah. And here is proof, as we mentioned on another program, classic songs, classic group, classic sound. Man, it's just classic.
A great addition to gospel music.
Yeah.
So thank you. We're thrilled about that.
So we want everybody to go check these guys out in the world of social media. Just Google Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. You'll come up with all sorts of great, interesting trivia about this group and find out where they're going to be appearing at and everything. Speaking of trivia, do you know how many times the wings of a hummingbird will flap in a second?
In a second, about 30.
Okay, well, we've tried that for two programs now, and she still got it wrong. We'll try it again in a later episode here of Gospel Music USA. Don't give up. We're certainly not. Hey, Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers are going to come back in just a few moments and sing a few more songs. Don't go anywhere. Gospel Music USA is on the air.
Welcome back to Gospel Music USA, and we're so blessed to have Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers with us, and they're going to sing for you right now a song called Satisfied.
may ask me if I'm happy, if I have sweet peace within, if I'm worried about tomorrow when I reach my journey's end. I'm satisfied with my Jesus. When he knocks, I'll let him in. He'll go with me through the valley, for I know he is my friend. Satisfied, satisfied. No trouble will ever get me down. When my eyes are closed in death, with my Lord I'll be at rest. Then you'll know I'm satisfied. If my friends, they all forsake me, if they turn me from their door, oh, if they sow no seeds of kindness, make the thorns in my path grow,
well, it won't matter over yonder
when I reach the other side. Oh, I'm gonna sit out with my Jesus.
Satisfied,
satisfied, oh,
satisfied, satisfied. No trouble will ever get me down. And when my eyes are closed in death, with my Lord I'll be at rest. Then you'll know I'm satisfied.
I've got that
old-time religion,
got that
old-time religion.
That is why
I'm satisfied.
One of our favorite songwriters is a cowboy by the name of Stuart Hamlin. Stuart was a rough and tumble fella, worked in the B-movies for a long time, and had a great career going, but his personal life was falling apart. He became an alcoholic and had several other issues that he had dealt with over a period of time that was actually ruining his life. He found himself one day, as the story goes, sitting in the bleachers of a great stadium listening to a message preached by Dr. Billy Graham. And before he knew what was going on, he was walking those steps toward the field of that great arena, and there he gave his heart and life to Jesus Christ. Things changed dramatically for Stuart. He began to attend some of the same parties that he had gone to before, but this time he had a different conversation. And I heard that when he approached his neighbor, next door neighbor, Mr. John Wayne of the great Western movies, and told John what had happened to him, that he didn't need alcohol anymore, that his life had totally changed because of a relationship with Jesus Christ. John Wayne said, you know, you could probably write a story about that or write a song about that. He knew that Stuart was a great songwriter. Stuart said, you know, John, it's no secret what God can do. And John said, that's it. That's the song you need to write. So Stuart wrote this great song, and Pastor Phil's going to sing it for us. It is no secret what God can do.
Another day is through. can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. With arms wide open, he'll pardon you. It is no secret what God.
Singing. I was over there on my Facebook and social media talking about you guys and how much I love your sound
Thank
and
you.
How unique it is. You know, you're bringing back the older Western songs as well as, you know, putting the nice harmonies and boy, it's what, and you produce, mm-hmm. you produce the group, am I right?
Yeah, well, I was there. They're not hard to work with. These guys are very talented.
Well, and you know, another thing, though, is all of the strings and the orchestration is just beautiful.
Thank you.
So, you know, and now, Johnny, how can the folks at home, and I know all of you are loving the show today. I know I am. And we're honored to have y'all with us. But tell us how they can get in touch with you because y'all are going to want to get this new album.
Best way is just to Google Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers, and there's a whole lot of different things that come up there, including our email address and all that kind of stuff.
That's great. One more time.
Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers.
I love that. Well, we are going to hear some more music from Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. And y'all, thank you all for joining us today on Gospel Music USA. Keep us in your prayers. Be sure to go on Facebook and like our page, and also be sure to check out the guys. And we're looking forward to hearing another song from you all. Thanks for joining us.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Every day,
every day,
every day,
everywhere,
every day,
I'll let my little light shine. Jesus gave me the light, I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus gave me the light, I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus gave me the light, I'm gonna let it shine.
Every day,
every day,
every day,
every day,
every day,
everywhere,
every day,
every day,
I'll let my little light shine.
Little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
This little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine.
This little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine.
Light of life.